Hi, I'm Cathy Liu, Seafood Technology Specialist for the University of Maryland Sea Grant Extension. In this video, we will be discussing the benefits of catching and eating Chesapeake Bay blue catfish. Next, we will learn about the environmental benefits of catching and eating Chesapeake Bay blue catfish from Dr. Jill Law with the Maryland Department of Natural Resources.
My name is Dr. Joseph Lowe, and I work for our freshwater fisheries program. I'm a program manager. One of the primary fisheries that I manage is largemouth bass, but I also work with our invasive species matrix team. And in Maryland, we have three, and they are northern snakehead, flathead catfish, and blue catfish.
Virginia introduced blue catfish into their rivers, thinking that it would support this trophy fishery. And unfortunately, the catfish, blue catfish, do tolerate brackish water, and they are a large river mobile species. So they escaped where they were introduced in the rivers in Virginia. They escaped into the main stem of the bay and then moved upstream into Maryland waters. So we caught blue catfish in the Potomac River first. That was in the mid-1980s. And then from there, abundance in the Potomac River just began soaring. And then over the past 10 years, we began seeing blue catfish spread beyond the Potomac River into our other rivers of Maryland in the Chesapeake Bay Basin. Because of their high level of abundance, as well as their large size, it's expected that through predation that they are affecting our ecosystems because they're preying upon species that are within the Chesapeake Bay watershed. So we're concerned about what that level of predation is doing to our resources in the bay. Some of those resources do include blue crab, which is, you know, the archetypal species for Maryland. Everyone loves Maryland blue crab. We also know that blue catfish consume other species of interest, like white perch, yellow perch. There's some evidence for consumption of striped bass, but there's also some concern that blue catfish could displace some of our native catfishes, such as white catfish, which is native to the Chesapeake Bay watershed. We are encouraging people when they catch a blue catfish to harvest it and consider consumption or some sort of beneficial use. We're working with University of Maryland, right, to try and promote consumption and let people know what the consumption advisories are for catfish. That's something that continues to come up. So we work with Maryland Department of Environment to provide them fish so that they can test them for PCBs and mercury so that they can craft more responsible consumption advisories. And, you know, we are also, you know, working with Salisbury University, right, to learn more about ecological impacts. And through that process, some of the fish get harvested, right, for the science. Not only are people being incentivized to harvest the fish, but those fish are also being used in science so that we can learn more about what these ecological impacts are in eastern shore rivers. The department tries to support those efforts because it drives harvest up a little bit, but I think more importantly, it also drives outreach and information. And all of that information is spread just through talking to one another